Hello developers, welcome back to the channel. Today in this lesson we are going to look into many-to-many relationship. It is slightly more complicated than one-to-one and one-to-many relationship. Let's look into an example. Let's say we have a post and a post may have many tags. Similarly, a tag may have many posts, and this is we call many-to-many relationship, because in this example, a post may have many tags and a tag may have many posts. Now, how we can implement this relationship? To create relationship between post and tag, we use third intermediate table, and that table is called pivot table. Now, let's implement this. We already have created this post model. So next, let's create a tag model. So in the terminal, here I'll run php artisan make model tag and I'm flag for migration. Now it's done. Let's see in the editor. Now we have tag model, and in the database migration, here is the migration for the tags table. Next, here I'll add table string name. That's all. Next, we will create a relationship between post and tag. So in the post model, here I'll create public function tags, and it will return $this belongs to many. In the first parameter, we pass the model name tag class. In the second parameter, we can pass the name of intermediate table, that is pivot table. If we follow the naming convention for the pivot table, then we can skip it. And the naming convention for the pivot table is that Laravel expects the name of two models in alphabetical order. So in our case, the two models are post and tag. And here P comes before T. So here the pivot table name should be post tag. Now let's create the migration for this table. So in the terminal, php artisan make migration, create post tag table, and here we pass create post tag. Now let's see. And here it has created the post tag. Next, here we create two columns, table big integer. First is the post ID and second is the tag ID. We don't need timestamp, so let's comment this. Now in the post.php, here we are following the naming convention. So here we can skip this second parameter. In case if you want to use different name for this pivot table, for example, maybe you want tag post. Now here it is not in alphabetical order, so it is not following the naming convention. So in that case, here we need to add second parameter tag post. If we follow the naming convention like this post tag, in that case, we can skip it or we can specify post tag. It will work. The third and fourth parameters are relation column's name. So right here in this post tag table, we have post ID and tag ID. So here the third column name should be post ID, the foreign key of the parent model, that is post. And the fourth column name is the tag ID, associated pivot key for this tag model. If we are following the naming convention, then it is optional. We can skip it. Otherwise, you can specify it like this. Right here, we are following the naming convention, so we can remove it. Now, let's run the migration. PHP artisan migrate. Tables are created. Next, let's close this. And in the web route, let's comment this. And so first let's create some tags. So here I'll say app tag create name is equal to, let's say Laravel. Another is php JavaScript, and last one Vue.js. Let's navigate to post route. Mass assignment exception. So in the tags model, here we'll add fillables name. Let's run this again, and here we get no error. Now let's see the database. Here in the tags, here we have four records. In the post table, we already have some posts that we have created in the last video. Our next step is to attach this tag to the post, and that will be stored here in the post tag table right here. So let's implement this. So let's remove this, and here we will fetch tag is equal to app tag first, and we also fetch post app post first. Next, to link this post with this tag, here we'll say $post tags, and here we will not say save like we used in the belongs to or has many relation. Here we will say attach and then $tag id, or we can add a model like this. Now let's refresh, and in the database here we can see post id 1 and here tag id is 1. Here we dump this post. Now let's comment this, dump this post, and here we will say with tags the relation name, and refresh. Now here in the relations we have collection of tags. Right now we have one item. We can also attach multiple tags, like here we pass collection of tags model, or we will pass IDs in the array like this. Now if we go to browser and refresh, and here we have four records, and post ID is associated with four tags. Let's comment this and refresh it again, and this time here we have collection of four tags. Let's comment this. Next, let's print this in the view. Right here in the with method, here we pass in array tags. Now this post will eager load user and tags. So in the post index, resources, views, posts, index, right here we'll create ql and for each loop $post tags as tag and li, and here we'll print $tag name. Now let's refresh, and for the first post we have four tags. Now let's change this tag to post id 2, and if we refresh, and we can see this tag associated to this post title. Similar to this attach, we can also use detach method to remove tag from this post. Let's see an example. So let's uncomment this, and here we want to detach tag id 2 from this post. Here you can see right now we have three tags attached to this post. Now if we refresh, now we have two tags. It has removed the PHP tag from this post. And in the database, we refresh, it has now three records. If you want to update tags for this post, so what you will do? First, you will detach all tags like this. This detach method without any tag ID, it will remove all tags from the post. And then we will call attach method. And in this attach method, we will pass new collection of tags or tag IDs like this. Right now this post has Laravel and Vue.js. Now if we refresh, it should change. Now it has PHP and JavaScript. Instead of this, another better way is using sync method. Now we don't need this detach method. Here we can say tag id 1 and tag id 4. Now let's go to browser, and here for this post we have PHP and JavaScript. Now refresh, and now it has Laravel and Vue.js. Now in the post model, if we add here pivot table post tag and then foreign key of the parent id, that is post id, and then associated relation key is tag id, and refresh, and here we go, it is working the same. Similar to this, we can create inverse relation in the tag model. So here we can say public function posts, and here we return $this belongs to many, and then we pass the model name, and here model name is post class. Next, in the web route, here I'll create another route for tags. Right here we will fetch all tags, and return tags index compact tags. Here we will also fetch posts. Now let's create this tags index view. Tags index.blade.php, and steal all this markup from post index and paste that right here. Now we can say here tags as tag, and here we say tag name. Next here we'll say tag posts as post. Next post title. In the browser, let's navigate to tags, and here we go, we get the tags and its posts, and we can use all the operations like attach, detach for these tags also, same as we used right here. And here in the tag model, in the post relation, if we are not following the naming convention for the pivot table, we can pass here pivot table name, that is post tag. Next is the foreign key id for the parent tag, that is tag id for this tag model, and then here second parameter is the post id. Here you can notice the difference. Right here we pass the tag id according to this parent tag model, and in the post model, here we have passed the post id according to the parent model. In the tag model, we have passed fourth post id for this post model. Now refresh, it should work the same. By default, timestamps not works with the pivot table. In case if in your project you have requirement to add timestamp, we will see how we can enable it in the next lesson. And we will also learn how we can add additional columns to this pivot table. So if you like the tutorial, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.